Weston McCatman, and this is the third bonus feature for Doctor Who Fan Audio Adventures. How and where do I work?
So I thought I'd give you a little tour of my workspace. So in the overall scheme of things, my desk is kind of in the center of the room. But of course it's facing the television. And the view that most of you get from the videos is the backside of the townhouse that I live in, which is the kitchen, the staircase, dining room. So I usually do most of my editing work from right here. And so that's my junky junk mail catch-all everything with little Matt Smith for inspiration. There's my little Sonic right there. Head scratcher for those headaches. And of course that's the old trusty all-in-one. Windows 8.1, I guess. And there's my fancy little keyboard. Digital camera. My cool little microphone set that I have. I have this microphone set with this mixing board. Couple of inputs. I think it's got four inputs. And then the output. My cool little light-up mouse. It changes color. There it goes. There you go. Cool little mouse. And my Canon printer, which is currently out of ink.
Alright, so I thought I would show you a little bit about how I construct these audio adventures. So, what you're looking at is Audacity. Now, Windows 8 has this cool snap feature that lets me snap two windows side by side so I can work side by side, so that's really, really helpful. So what you're looking at is, this is the Return of Fandahl completed, what I've done so far and as far as editing. And when I made this video, I'm only about 8 minutes in. I also need the script open, so I'll know where I am. So this is the section we're on. And I'm getting ready to add, "I don't want to hurt you, Aaron, but I'm taking a line and we're leaving." So that's the line I'm looking for. So over here you're going to see Aaron's voices, his lines, and I have a third window open with Tom's lines. And so here you'll see Tom's lines, I believe. Yeah, those are Tom's lines. And the actress who plays Alon sends me her lines in email by section. And so I just download those and import them directly into Audacity. So the line I'm looking for is from Tom. And there it is. Right there's the line we're looking for. Okay, so I'm going to copy that section over to my voices section. Let's see. And attaching it right about there. And so now this should flow. Okay, and so I continue to do that, and I continue to build and build and build the script from these sections. Now, Audacity also lets me do a cool thing about adding effects, and so I can add different effects to the voices. That's how I add the reverb that you heard when they were speaking to each other in the first episode. I added the echoes. In the Fandahl Aaron's voice that you'll hear in episode 2, you'll hear me do a lot of weird things to his voice to get it to sound kind of odd and interesting. And so eventually, this is what I call my first pass or my voice pass. And so notice that this is Return of Fandahl Voices. The next thing I'll do is that I'll add sound effects, and I'll add a track to this and add it under this. I'll save that as probably Fandahl Voices Effects. Then I'll come back a third time and add incidental music, and you'll see that called Return of Fandahl Music, or I may call that Return of Fandahl Final, meaning that this is the final cut. And so eventually, let me show you what it's going to look like in the editor. And so eventually you have something that looks like this, where I have the pictures across the top, I have the audio track second, I have a couple of extra pictures and things thrown in. Then you hear some extra sound effects. And so this is what it'll eventually look like all put together. So this is how an episode of Doctor Who Fan Audio Adventures is created. Come back and see episode 2, July 1st. Subscribe for more content.